you guys for that.
Thank you.
my belt is squeaking on my bass, so I'm taking it off. That's what I'm doing. Full disclosure.
Hey, Paul, this is a church.
Okay. This interlude was not supposed to have talking. We're supposed to go right into the next song.
Oh.
Sorry. Just a little off now.
But that would have been a little weird if I just took my belt off.
No, you're right. And you don't want to scratch the bass either.
No, it's not the scratching, it was squeaking.
Oh, squeaking, you don't want the squeaking. Man.
I didn't hear it.
Well, it was bothering me.
Yeah.
Cool, okay. So, now we're going to play a song called Tell Me What You're Going to Do Now. The last song is called Monkey Trouble. And both these songs are in the key of G, because the baby that was crying cries in the key of G. It's true. All her notes were G. So we played those two songs because of that. All right. This one's called Tell Me What You're Gonna Do Now.
Thank you.
that we just played her off our brand new CD, which we're currently releasing, just pushing it off into the world, hoping that it can fly. And this third song is actually the first track off our new CD. It's called Leadfoot. It's written by Paul. So we're going to play it for you right now. Instrumental songs, and that's kind of more or less what the main MO, the main like mission statement of this band is. And that's like what the CD is. It's our instrumental original music. Every band needs a backup plan. So we decided that if indeed you hate that, then we should like sing some kind of old time and bluegrass songs too, so that we can appeal to everybody. So that's what we're going to do now. We're going to do a Carter Family song. So if you really just are not feeling the last three things we played, hopefully you'll enjoy this. It's called 50 Miles of Elbow Room.
Trouble and Tell Me What You're Gonna Do Now, respectively, or in order, first and second. And so here's another one by Joran.
It's called Grandpa's Cheese Barn. Brittany has to tune her fiddle in strange, unorthodox tuning. Right? Are there other tunes in this tuning?
What?
Are there other tunes in this tuning?
I don't know. I bet. I think there probably are. It's like a...
it's like a D chord.
Yeah, it's like a D chord. It's all A's and D's. So, instead of fifth, 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 it's like fourth, fifth, fourth. In case you're curious. And it sounds like that. It's like a palindrome. I can't say that word. Yeah.
Oh, wow.
That fulfills our educational requirement.
Is this the pick we're using?
Yeah.
Don't let the red one anymore?
So it's so good to be back here. I was here about exactly 1 year ago with it's kind of like a ragtag ensemble with harpist Maeve Gilchrist and percussive dancer Nick Garris. I don't know if anybody was there for that.
Yeah.
But this next tune is, I guess, significant. It's been here before. And I'd just written it right before that gig. So I played it, I eagerly showed it to Nick, who learned it, and I remember playing it. And it ended up on our CD that we recorded in, last January, or this last January.
Thank you.
six, seven. Churchyard.
Yeah.
Is the next song. And Joran's gonna sing. So normally he would introduce it, but I thought he was tuning.
That was great.
I'm just trying to keep things real slick.
It's like a carried away here.
What's the name of the last song?
The Decade.
It's called The Decade.
Another Joran Tice original.
Cool. This is a great old song that I heard this from the singing of Martin Carthy. So it's called The Old Churchyard. I so well know those paths need a soft green sward. Friends
slumber in there that we want to regard. We will trace out their names in the old churchyard. Mourn not for them, for their trials are o'er, and why weep for those who can be no more. Though sweet is their slumber, though cold in heart, their pillows may be in the old churchyard. And I know that it's vain when our friends depart to breathe kind words to an aching heart. And I know that the joy of life is marred when we follow lost friends to the old churchyard. But were I at West beneath yonder tree, why
to end this first set, and it's a tune of Brittany's called Down the Hatch.
Into the A4. Yeah, that should work, right?
What's the first part?
Make it weird.
Or wait, no. That's the other tune.
Okay. G.
D.
D.
That's just D? Oh. Oh, yeah. Cool.
Okay. So we're going to do a set of some old-timey tunes. The guys will start off with a tune called Blackjack Grove. We learned from the playing of the banjo player Adam Hurt. And then we'll go into a tune called Duck River.
Yay.
This one's for Paul. it's from a fiddle player called John Salyer, but I learned it from Bruce Malski, one of my fiddle mentors. It was awesome. Yeah.
Kind of interchange the tunes sometimes, so.
Yeah.
Sorry.
here's one of the first tunes that we came together to play that was written by Jordan. So it's about 7 years old.
Yeah. Yeah. It's seven.
It's called Forest Waltz. Thank you.
Which means although.
Thank you.
got such a nice platform over there. I don't know if you guys can see this. His tuner is an app on an iPhone.
My regular one's out of batteries. Less than them.
And it's sitting on the little stand built onto the pump organ that's made for holding a candle stick. And it's glowing. That kind of summarizes our life right there. We're playing such archaic instruments, you know, when you think about what's going on, like in a lot of music today. But we also use a bunch of new stuff all the time. Thoughts?
Discuss. This week on town meeting. This is a tune Brittany wrote called El Camino.
Thank you.
church back in.
Is that a good, is this a good time to tell people about our instruments, maybe? Since you were really utilizing your low string.
Sure.
We'll start. Because someone was asking, and I thought I should just tell everybody, because you all seem like you're interested in this kind of thing. Brittany's fiddle has 5 strings.
Yeah.
And so normal fiddles have 4, you know, and then this has 5, and this has an extra bottom string.
Mm-hmm. The C string on the bottom, so it's kind of like a fiddle and a viola smushed together in a fiddle-sized body. So, yeah, that's the extra one.
So, and which leads me to my next point, which is that I also have an extra low, I have extra low notes as well. I also have a low C. That was hers, and then here's mine. Whose is better? That's what this is.
It's like subsonic, like you can't even tell what note it is anymore.
This is a C extension, so it extends the fingerboard further and longer and lower. So this string, instead of ending here like these ones do, it keeps on going all the way up here and through the scroll to the tuning peg.
Wait, so when you change your string, do you have to take it apart?
No. Yeah, so it's just installed on there, and a lot of bass players and orchestras do this because some orchestral pieces have bass music for the low notes. So.
Guitar. You know it, you love it. Well, that brings us to the end of our set, unfortunately. but thank you guys so much for coming out.
We'll play one more thing.
Yeah, we wanted to play more, just kind of because we lost our band keys, but they're probably around here somewhere. But yeah, thank you. This is such a wonderful. It's a real treat to be back here, and thanks so much to Paul, Claudia for making this happen.
Yeah.
For you guys. Such a beautiful room, and it's just so cool to like pull up this like hill, this like in this like glorious sunset to this like old chapel. And like that's where you're gonna be playing tonight. It's so wonderful. So thanks for making this happen. And please sign our mailing list if indeed you want to stay in touch. It's sitting in that over on the table there. And thank you for coming out. It's been a lot of fun. And once again, that's Brittany Haas playing this song.
Paul Kowart playing the bass. And Joran Tice on the guitar.
We're going to leave you with a John Hartford song. much, guys.
It really is fun to play this music in here. Pretty unusual to get to do this.
Yeah, I just got this like electric guitar pickup kind of system because I felt like I should, and I hate it. And it sounds bad, but it's loud, which is, I guess, what matters in most places. So it's awesome not to have to use this godforsaken thing I just bought that I'm supposed to be excited about. Because this just sounds so good, and why can't we just do this every night? Alright, we're gonna leave you with a tune we learned. It's actually the first thing we ever played together, like a long time ago. More or less. Like the first thing we like sat down formally, like let's like make something more than, you know, let's like arrange or write a tune.
That's right.
And it's from a woman named Anne Bjord Lien, who lives in Norway. She's a great hardanger, traditional Norwegian fiddle player. It's called Flutterin.
There was like a gig, like exactly like this, with a different fruit outside.
Cool. Melon Mondays.
The Tomato Tuesday. Yeah. Anyways, this rules. This place is great. Yeah.